హలో ఫ్రెండ్స్, వెల్కమ్ టు వాస్టెక్ ఛానల్. దిస్ వసంత్ నాయక్ ఫ్రమ్ కెనరా ఇంజనీరింగ్ కాలేజ్. వీఆర్ ఇన్ మాడ్యూల్ 5, కంటిన్యూయింగ్ అవర్ మాడ్యూల్ 5 డిస్కషన్ ఆఫ్ ఏఆర్ఎం ఆఫ్ 17CS44 సిలబస్ ఆఫ్ యూటీయూ ఫార్ ఫోర్త్ సెమిస్టర్ ఆఫ్ ఐఎస్ అండ్ సిఎస్ స్టూడెంట్స్. టుడే విల్ డిస్కస్ మూవ్ ఇన్స్ట్రక్షన్. సో వాట్ ఈస్ మూవ్ ఇన్స్ట్రక్షన్? మూవ్ ఇన్స్ట్రక్షన్ కాపీస్ ఎన్ into a destination register RD, where N is a register or immediate value. You can see here syntax of the move instruction. Instruction followed by condition, followed by S, followed by operands. So as I said, S is a suffix you have to add if you want to update the flag register. So move, where RD is the destination register and N is the source register or a constant value. So you can see here one example, move R7 R5. What it will do? It will move R5 to R7. So free condition is this one, forced condition is this one. Forced condition indicates the status of the register after execution. Now barrel shifter, very important question. So in the above example, we saw move instruction where N is a simple register. N can be more than a simple register. It can also be a register that has been pre-processed by the barrel shifter prior to being used by the data processing instruction, that is by the ALU. So a barrel shifter is a register which has got unique powerful features. That is the ability to shift the 32-bit binary pattern from one of the source register left or right by specific number of times before it enters ALU. So what is the use of free processing? Free processing will help in achieving division or multiplication of a power of 2. Multiplication by a power of 2. So now it will improve the performance. You can see what is barrel shifter. It is a digital circuit that can shift the data word by specified number of bits without the use of any sequential logic. Sequential logic is the logic which makes use of one is clock signal such as flip-flops or shift register, etc. So but barrel shifter is a pure combination logic. So implementation is very easy and not costlier. So you can see a barrel shifter. So what barrel shifter will do? It will take one of the operand and it will shift that either left or right. When you do the left shift, it is called as division. When you do the right shift, it is called as multiplication. For example, let me write here one pattern of the binary 0010. So when you say left shift, so this becomes so for this, now the value is equal to 2. The value of this in decimal is 2. When you left shift, this becomes 4. That is 0100. This is this one. Now you right shift this one. That time this becomes 010. That means right shift leads to division. This one division and left shift leads to multiplication by power of 2. That you have to remember. So barrel shifter will do that operation and finally it will be processed by the arithmetic logic unit. This will improve the performance. So what are the operation done by the barrel shifter? Barrel shifter will do the following operation. So logical shift left, logical shift right, arithmetic shift right, and rotate right extend. So you have to, from the exam point of view, you have to remember. These two columns. If it is better, if you remember these two columns, that is the operation done by the barrel shifter. For example, you can see here now. R5 is equal to 5, R7 is equal to 8. The value of R5 is assigned as 5, R7 is 8. Now, move R7, R5, LSL2. That means R5 is left shift by 2, then it is moved to R7. So R5 is right now 5. We will write here. It is 5. 0, 1, 0, 1. When you left shift by 2, so let me write in 8 bit. When you left shift by 2, this becomes 0, here it becomes 1, then it becomes 0, 1, and here 0 enters. Now, what is the value of this 1 in binary? You will see. Now, this is 8, 4, 2, 1. This is 16. 16. Now, we are not bothered about this. This is 0. 16 and 4, 20. Now, this becomes 20. The 20 is moved to R7. So, this is the final condition. R5 remains 5, but after left shift 20, it becomes 20. That is, 20 is moved to R7. So this job is done by barrel shifter. So this will improve the performance. So you can see here in the exam, if you are interested, if you have time, you can write this one also. Here you see some value 1000, this is the value, 32 bit value, and this 32 bit value is last 4 bit is 100, that is 8. And first 4 bit, rest of the bits are not shown here. First 4 bit is 4. So if you shift this one by 1, then as I said, when left shift always leads to multiplication. But here 31st bit, when it move, then carry flag becomes enabled. Here carry flag was not there, carry flag becomes enabled. And this bit, when you move, this becomes 8. So you see, this is in hexadecimal, please remember. So each digit will take 4 bits. Like this, how many digits are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 4 into 8, 32 bit. Here it is shown in 32 bit. All bits are not shown. Starting bit and ending bits are shown. So now ending 4 digits becomes 000. That is shown here. See this one. Starting 4 digits becomes 100. This one shown here. See. So that is the example. So in the exam you can write what is the use of barrel shifter. Now we can use a moves instruction. When you use some conditional flags, then you need to attach or suffix S to the instruction, otherwise it will not update this one flag register. So here you can see free condition. So CPSR is written here. Why CPSR written? Because CPSR shows because you know CPSR shows flag status, right? Yeah, this is a flag, and CPSR in user mode. He is saying here he wants to say this. Author wants to say CPSR in user mode. Now you take R0, this is R1. After moving, carry flag is enabled, and this is the first condition. You can see what is R0 and what is the R1. This is the first condition. This will update the carry flag. But if you use only move, that will not update the flag register. Please remember here. So now, in a barrel shifter, shifting operation we have seen. Syntax for the different barrel shifter from the exam point of view, if it is possible, you can remember syntax or different operations, immediate and register. This is the two operation with the move, then logical shift by left by immediate, then logical shift right by register. Logical shift right by immediate, logical shift right by register, arithmetic shift right by immediate, arithmetic shift right by register, rotate right by immediate, rotate right by register. All these you can write along with the main table. So I told you main table because sometimes for some students it is not possible to remember all this syntax. Better you remember these operations and try to explain this operation with the example. Example you can remember, syntax somewhat difficult to remember, even though you have to know the syntax properly. So here you see, as I said in the previous example, we have, these are the operations with our barrel shifter. This table you can extend further. In logical shift, how many operations are there? Logical shift right, arithmetic shift right, as I said now, you can write. You can include one more column here. What is that column? That column is this one. This one. This one you can include, or you can write this separately. So next one is arithmetic instruction. Please remember, as I said, data processing instruction contains move, arithmetic, logical, compare, and multiply. We have five to six type of instruction. First one is a data processing instruction, then data processing instruction, branch instruction, load and store instruction, load and store instruction, then software instruction, program software instruction, software interrupt instruction, program status register instruction. Five types of main instructions are there. In that, data processing instruction is this one. This one you have to explain. In that, right now you have completed only move instruction. Now you have to complete. Now you have to start arithmetic, then logical, compare, and multiply. After that, you have to move to branch instruction. After that, you have to move to load and store instruction. After that, software interrupt instruction. Then program status register instruction. So in the exam, the question may be like, for 10 marks, explain any two types of instructions in ARM. Then you have to explain data processing instruction or branch instruction or anything. Or they may ask, explain data processing instruction and branch instruction. Or they may ask in data processing instruction in detail. You have to explain all these things. So please remember this point. Now arithmetic instruction, we have ADC, add, RSB, reverse subtraction, then RSC, reverse subtract with the carry, then subtract with the carry, subtract instruction. So ADC, RD, destination register, is nothing but RN plus N plus carry. That is, if you write add R3, R1, R2. R3 is a destination here. R1 and R2, what I can say, RN and N, something like that. So add two 32-bit values, see here. Then reverse subtract. Reverse subtract means N minus RN. Then uh, So let me correct one point. R3 is a destination. Here R1 is also destination because sometimes you can write add R1 and R2. That will add R2 and R1 and store the result in R1. That's why it depends on how you use it. Next instruction is RSE, reverse subtract with the carry. Then subtract with the carry. Subtract two 32-bit values. So we have to see one by one. Na? So let me start first. First instruction will take example. So here sub R0, R1, R2. It will subtract R1 and R2. So R2 from R1 and result is stored in R0. So here you can see. So what is the value? You by seeing this 2 minus 1, 1. So first you can see R0 is equal to 1. Yes. Yeah, correct. So that is a subtract example. Anyway, now RSB, reverse subtract. What is reverse subtract RSB? What we did for subtract? Destination minus source. Here source minus destination. Source minus destination. So you see here R0 is 0, R1 is 77. So RSB, the instruction RSB R0 R10, it will reverse subtract. That means it will subtract R1 from 0 and store the result in R0. So R1 from 0, 0 minus R1. Now you represent minus R1. Minus R1 you will represent by using two's complement. What is here? Two's, this one, R1. R1 is this one. So let me use pen. R1 is equal to 0, 0, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Please remember, this is each digit will take 4 bit. You don't think 0 is digit. Zero is a binary bit. No. 0 is a digit. Each digit will take 4 bits. So like this, how many digits are here? 8. 32 bits. So hexadecimal format, it is representation. It is not binary. Hexadecimal, each digit will take 4 bit. Please remember, some of the students will get confused. 0 means they will take binary. No, it is not binary. It is in hexadecimal. Please remember. Now, you take the complement of this one. When you take the complement of this one, F. This is F. This is F. This is F. This is F, this is F, this is F, 2's complement, and 7 you have to subtract from F, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 8, 9, 10, 10 means A, B, C, D, E. So you will get EF, you will get 8 here, here also you will get 8. And this is 1's complement. While adding 1 to the 2's complement, you will get this value. So I will not go in detail. You know how to represent minus R1 in 2's complement. 2's complement, use your calculator and or you can manually you can do. Better you do manually, you will understand better. So this is a 2's complement. So now here you can see subs. When you use this instruction, flag is, see here, flag is not affected, here flag is affected. So, dear friends, we have completed two instructions, sub and RSB, reverse subtraction. Like that, we have completed add, we know add with carry. Reverse addition, don't ask reverse addition. We have reverse subtraction, reverse addition is not there. It looks like funny, reverse addition, 7 plus 5, 5 plus 7, both are same. So don't ask me, reverse addition, reverse subtraction is there. So now next one is reverse subtracted the carry of 32-bit values. So reverse subtraction with the carry of 32-bit value, this one you will see here, this one. One thing you have to see here, please remember this one. Here you have to note one changes. During the subtraction, carry flag becomes one. During the subtraction, carry flag becomes zero. During the addition, carry flag becomes one. This changes you have to remember in ARM. ARM, during the subtraction, carry flag becomes zero. But in 8086, when there is a subtraction borrow, carry flag becomes 1. When there is addition, carry is there, carry flag becomes 1. But in ARM, during the subtraction, carry flag becomes 0. Addition, carry flag becomes 1. So, reverse subtract with the carry of 32-bit values. When you do this one, see, if you use, since carry flag is 0, if you use 0 here, there is no meaning. That's why they have used this symbol, negative of this 0. What is negative of 0? Negative of 0 is 1. So that is why this is explanation carry flag. That indicates RDN minus RN, that is reverse subtraction, minus 1. Similarly, subtract with carry RN minus N, invert of carry flag, because subtraction carry flag becomes 0. During the subtraction, when borrow is there, carry flag becomes 0 in ARM. So if you use same 0, no effect. So that's why you have to invert that one here, this one SBC. But in addition, you can see RDN plus carry. These are the important arithmetic instructions you studied here. Next one is the logical instructions. Logical instructions we have AND OR, exclusive OR, and logical bit clear. So AND operation we know, logical AND, and syntax you can write. Logical OR operation we know, and logical OR operation is just like addition. Exclusive OR operation we know, and from our previous theory, and bit clear. Logical bit clear is nothing but it will do first NOT operation, after that AND operation. First NOT operation, then AND operation. First NOT, there are two operands, right? Source it will do NOT operation, then it will AND that with the RN. So this is important. OR operation, you can see what is the OR operation here. So OR operation, R1 and R2, it will OR and it will store the result in R0. Then next one is a logical bit clear. Logical bit clear, what it will do? It will do first NOT operation, then it will do AND operation. So first we will take here NOT operation of this one. We will take the NOT operation. We will do the NOT operation of R2. What is the NOT operation of R2? This is, see, this indicates it is in binary. NOT operation of R2 is 1010. This is the NOT operation of R2. That we will AND it with this one. 1111. That time you will get answer 1010. That is stored in R0. So first NOT operation of N, then AND with the RN, that is RD. So this you have to write in the exam point of view. So compare instruction. Next instruction is compare instruction. So already now we have completed all these instruction, and this video size time has increased more than 24 minutes. I will stop this here, and the next session, next video you will see, we will start with the compare instruction.